Randy and them have done a great job getting this individuals, but it's cost a lot of money. It's cost a lot of money. Where does that come from? Hey, we gotta be competitive. We gotta be on the field financially as well. We can't be 31 financially and be number one on the football field. They work hand in hand, hand in hand. Now let us examine the so-called guaranteed income. In the category, and what they offering, I can tell you, and I'm repeating myself, I know, keeps us on the bottom. Just keeps us on the bottom, and that's not where we can be. Should also closely examine what the saints mean by the term guarantee. They do not guarantee any set payment or any amount by merely saying that if the payment is not forthcoming or produced on a remedy of recourse to deduct that shortfall that they didn't make from the penalty due by us at the end of the lease term. Did you hear what I said? In other words, they're not guaranteeing anything. All they saying to me is, look, if we don't make some of these, if we don't give you $2 million from concessions, if that didn't work out and then we guarantee that to you, you can deduct it from the penalty you have when you leave. When you leave at the end of the 2005 or 2007 season. What kind of deal is this? Who ever heard of a guarantee like this? What are we talking about? This is sort of, I forget what you call that when you go there and they move the cards around and stuff, you know? That's what it reminds me of, that we're doing. While the state attempts to guarantee revenue through the exit fees, which I just mentioned, they also propose to raise the exit fee from $25 million to $75 million. So what they're saying to me is, Tom, you paying for it someplace if this didn't work out for you. This don't work. If we can't build a new stadium or we can't support a new stadium or the market's not here to do it, then you just pay it. You pay it. I don't know where they think that money's coming from. I'm like the rest of us, you know. If you get in $2 and you spend $4, you're minus $2. You don't have an extra $2. I already told you about the investments that we've put in. I heard from time to time people talk about I paid $75 million. They forgot about the $175 million I've had to put in this club since then. Well, don't get me too excited. A further concrete example of prospective but non-existent revenue is the so-called naming rights. Although they show we're going to get $3 million, that's part of this guarantee thing, but it's not guaranteed, okay? That's not even in the payoff deal. They admitted that they have no contract, no firm prospects, and no set amount. Why do you put $3 million? Why are they kidding the fans and the public that they're going to have $3 million when they don't have $3 million? It'd be like you and I saying, gee, I'd like to walk outside and find $3 million laying in the street. Or maybe $1 million, whatever. You're like, that's the same thing we're talking about here. There's no difference. The state also, over the same period of time, talked about adding about $14 million to a ticket tax. This pass-through item that only the fans will pay is as unfair to the brass, Tulane, and other users of the facility, and unfair to our fans who already think that ticket prices are too high. How can we add a tax? Who wants to add another tax on? For what? Nobody wants to do that. Why don't we just say we'll increase sales tax for everything? Nobody wants to do that. It's unfair. And nobody wants a tax on the tickets. That's not a way to give us the money. Hey, that don't make sense to me. We said we're not interested in adding a tax on tickets. And we don't want Tulane or the Brass or anybody else to pay our freight. The financial problems which we face today were not created by me, but as the economic reality of operating a National Football League in one of the smallest and most financially depressed markets. This is what the problem is. This is the reason that the Saints' economic performance is last in the National Football League. And after a most successful season in the history of the Saints, only 40,000 season tickets have been sold. You know why? Because nobody wants to buy a season ticket in the Saris. If you don't want, you don't believe me, go up in the terrace in the end zones. There's some little boxes up there, way up there on the top. By the way, that's where we're going to move the press box. You ought to take a look at it, because it's only 41 steps up there to get there. And I want you to know that's where it's going to be. That's what they suggest where you go. Go up there, and you're going to see how great that is, the report from that area. And that's why people won't buy any tickets up there. It's not because they don't like the football. It's not because they don't want to be there. It's because after they sit there for one season, I have had enough of this. They have had enough of it. First of all, when you get into the curves, which is about 12,000 seats, you can't hardly see but half the game. What kind of place is this we operate out of? Sure, it was a great place 30 years ago. There was a lot of great things 30 years ago, and I was a lot better, a lot younger 30 years ago. But I'm going to tell you, it's not the same anymore. Why is there 26 new stadiums out there? Instead, everybody's saying, gee, what we got is what we ought to have. No. It's because of fact today, make a real thing out of it. Look at this right here. Wouldn't that be wonderful to have this sitting right there? That one there is right out Canal Street there. Wonderful sitting out there to have a whole day's event or many events. And all other times, all the new growth that would happen. They talk about there's some pictures here someplace on Padre Street and what it looked like before the dome and what happened to it after. We're talking about the extension of Canal Street. We talked about maybe Algiers Point to do something with that. We talked about maybe right downtown near the convention center in another area that needed to be rebuilt, not just for a stadium, but a whole. I don't want to be in the development business. I only want to be in the football business. I've got out of everything else. But this is what we're talking about, a whole redevelopment of an area, something that our community needs very badly. And look, we went in. I have the feel we ought to be working on a new stadium right now. The state told me and the city, hey, Tom, we don't have the funds to do it today. Maybe in a couple of years from now we could do it. And I said, okay, I don't think that's the way to go. I think we ought to be going ahead now. We ought to be in the front of things, not behind the other 31 clubs out there. Why do we want to stay in last place? Why do we want to stay in last place? I don't understand it. But I said, okay, let's give it a few years then before we develop this wonderful thing for our community, because this is what it's going to take. I understand, hey, if we can't do it, market's not here, financially there's nothing out there, then we might have to look at other alternatives. Today, the state has really pushed it in our face. They slammed the door on us. It wasn't us. They slammed the door on us. And they give you numbers and facts that make no sense whatsoever. With that, I'll be glad to take some questions. All right, Peter Finney. I don't know what's the difference between Buffalo and New Orleans. What do you mean? They went to the Super Bowl four times. We haven't made it yet. Well, they got an outdoor stadium, for one. That's a big difference in what we have. And that, you know, I don't run Buffalo and what they do. The community itself came up and did a lot for them financially. But they got a football stadium. It was built for football. It wasn't built for any other purpose. It's not a dual-purpose facility. It was built for football. And they made about $70 million worth of improvements. But they also, lease runs out here in 2006. They most probably have to step. They got a patch deal. They're going to step up again. There it goes again.
Mr. Benson, where you propose the state get the money to pay its share of the new stadium?
Well, when the Superdome was built, the hotel motel tax was set up for that purpose, huh? The Superdome is now paid for, or will be paid for pretty quick. That money maybe ought to be used for that purpose. Now, the other things that they did with the money, maybe in building an arena or other things like that, ought to be taken over by some other responsible thing. But the 4% hotel motel tax was originally set up for that purpose. It was set up so we would have a National Football League club here. That was the reason it was set up. Not to build a dome, to bring a National Football League club.
Mr. Benson, then what about the...
Wait, one at a time. Mary's next.
Your representatives this morning tell the state that their options were to go to Mississippi or to sell the
team? Our representatives have told the state that we would, I don't know if they said option, we would say that we wanted to keep the New Orleans Saints in the Gulf South. And so our next step would be to talk to Mississippi, because it is in the Gulf South, and it was always my feeling that if we couldn't make a deal maybe in Louisiana, we couldn't do what we needed to be done, and then Mississippi was willing to do that, we keep this team here for us, we keep it for our fans, we keep it for the media, we keep it for everything. We're only talking about a few more miles away, and if you look around the league, most clubs are in that area like that. So... yes, we did tell them that, and we did say that if we couldn't do that, if that didn't work out, if the state of Louisiana didn't work out, if Mississippi and the Gulf South couldn't work out, then the next step would be for me to perhaps sell the club. Because I couldn't sit here and let this club go down the tube like it's going to go down. That's the reason to sell it. It's going to go right down the tube.
Yes, sir. The state says that they could do it in 2008. You have said before that you wanted it by 2006. Is 2008 final?
No, there's no guarantee for the state they would do it by 2008. You know what the state's offer is? The state says by 2005, I think, or 6, they will decide whether they're going to remodel the Superdome or build a new stadium. And if we don't like it, we can leave at the end of 2008 or 2006 or 2007. That's what their proposal is. It's nothing. It's like, you know, no guarantees or anything. Wait, young man,
Benson, you say their incentives aren't guaranteed. They say they are. Would it take a flat-out cash guarantee from the state?
You've been listening to a news conference with Saints owner Tom Benson, a very angry and upset Tom Benson, emphatically denying that he broke off negotiations with the state. In fact, suggested that the state is misrepresenting the facts, saying that the state never offered any guaranteed revenue.